There's huge reserves of water on the moon, on the order of 400 billion liters, you know, 100 billion gallons of water. And if you have huge amounts of water and continuous power, then you just need a good habitat and you can live there. I work with multiple space companies right now. It's a super exciting time because spaceflight has gotten radically simpler and safer. And when you make something simpler and safer, it gets cheaper. And if you can radically drop the cost of some sort of transportation, like cars or airplanes or trains or something, it changes how you do things and who has access. And it, as you say, it's to the point now where like a tourist, you have to be wealthy still, but a tourist can buy a ride to space. You know, that's brand new. And it's easy to get all distracted by, you know, billionaires and Bill Shatner, you know, flying to space. But the reality of that is that if you are trying to set up a business in space, using taking advantage of the vacuum of space or the weightlessness of space, or do something on the surface of the moon, it has never been more possible than it is right now. And that's the really big change. It's like it's like we just invented a whole new way to get somewhere, and we've discovered a whole new continent of the moon and a whole new capability. And it gives us great insight about the Earth itself. The little satellites that are going around the world measuring, you know, what's going on with the ice cap and the density and the volume of the ice in Greenland and Antarctica and the temperatures of the oceans and the levels of the oceans and the weather patterns and the constituents in the atmosphere and all the lakes of the world and the rivers. You can measure all of those effortlessly from space constantly and really, take the temperature of the world. And so, easy and cheap access to space really enables our understanding of the planet. And plus, you know, it's fun in the news to talk about, some other famous person going to space too. In the next 12 months, there are 11 lunar landing missions, like almost one a month. You know, that shows how much transportation has changed. And as you say, we're building a couple different rockets that can take people to the moon, and not just to be the early explorers like we did when I was growing up, but actually to start taking advantage of the moon, to start settling there, to treat it like we just discovered a continent that was bigger than Africa, that we know almost nothing about. A couple really important discoveries that we've made about the moon. One is, there's always solar power at the poles because the moon is perfectly upright. So you get eternal power. The other is there's huge reserves of water on the moon, on the order of 400 billion liters, 100 billion gallons of water. And if you have huge amounts of water and continuous power, then you just need a good habitat and you can live there. And so that's pretty interesting. And we really don't understand the geology of the moon. We've literally just scratched the surface. So it's tremendous potential if we can just get there and back cheap enough that it makes sense. And that's sort of the step we're at right now. And the combination of new invention, innovation driven by private companies and commercial companies working in concert with the governments of the world and all the 70 different space agencies that all the countries around the world have. It's kind of like a whole new frontier driven by human innovation and invention. And so, yeah, pretty exciting time to be alive. Are we alone or not? To me, that's the big question. And we've been wondering since we've looked up, right? Is this all there is? Are we it? And it's kind of a two-part question. If there is life somewhere else, what is that going to mean to us? You know, and that's pretty important. And what can we learn? And is it a threat? Or, you know, what does that mean? But the other is, if there isn't other intelligent life in the universe, then we need to recognize just what an incredible rare set of circumstances we are. And look at the responsibility we have not to just get lost in our daily mire of competitiveness and maybe think about the legacy and the capability that we offer and get interplanetary and get all of our eggs out of one basket and try and not squander this rare history, a historic opportunity. And maybe the little rover that's drilling into Mars right now will find a fossil, maybe not. Or maybe the James Webb telescope, because it's going to be able to see atmospheres around planets that are orbiting other stars we may show that there is life on a planet orbiting, I don't know, Alpha Centauri. And so those discoveries, I think, are going to be really important for us to try and internalize into our culture and our awareness and our decision making.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to our Narcity channel to see more great content.